Hello everyone, welcome back to Wondershare Recoverit, which is a tool that is designed to recover data in various formats. And we're back with yet another episode, in which we will be talking about the different types of audio format and their significance within the media world. Now, when it comes to audio files, the majority of users only really know one single format, i.e. MP3. But you might be surprised to know that there are actually dozens of audio formats that many creators use in their projects. Now, it is worth pointing out that all of these audio formats are designed to serve a specific purpose. So, in this episode, we will talk about some of the most popular audio file formats along with what their real-life uses are. But before we go any further, make sure to tap on the subscribe button below so that you never miss out on any future updates. Now, before talking about the common audio file formats, we would like to point out that all of these formats fall within one of three categories: either uncompressed audio formats, lossless compressed, or lossy compressed. Now, keep those three names in mind, as we are going to discuss them in more detail later in the episode. For now, though, let's start with a list of the best audio file extensions that is used in the media world. WAV file format used to be one of the most popular uncompressed audio types in the 90s and early 2000s. Usually it was used to store audio recordings on CD discs. Today though, WAV has pretty much become obsolete. Hardly anyone uses it to store audio files, although many recording studios do prefer recording audio using a conventional WAV format. AIFF is another uncompressed audio file format that was designed by Apple to store audio recordings on CDs. But like other Apple products, even AIFF format was only exclusive to the Apple ecosystem. It was most commonly used with Apple products, and the tech giants has even released a new modern-day version of AIFF known as AIFF-C. Now, the only difference is that the C variant is a compressed audio format. PCM stands for Pulse Code Modulation, and it's a technique that automatically converts analog audio files into a digital format. Now, the PCM format has become the go-to file format for people to store audio on CDs and DVDs. Even today, PCM is globally renowned as a file format to store audio recordings in an uncompressed manner. FLAC is a lossless compressed audio file format that can compress audio files up to 60% without losing any quality whatsoever. FLAC audio these days is used heavily to store audio files in a compressed format. In fact, some people even call it the best alternative to MP3, because FLAC can contain all of the metadata within an audio file. ALAC stands for Apple Lossless Audio Codec. And as the name implies, this is a lossless compressed audio format that was designed and released by Apple. It was first introduced back in 2004, but it didn't really gain much popularity until about 2011, when Apple decided to make the format royalty-free. Again, being an Apple product though, ALAC is mainly used in different types of iDevices, such as Macs, iPhones, and iPads. WMA stands for Windows Media Audio, and this is another type of lossless compressed audio file format that was designed and managed by Microsoft. It's a native audio format on the Windows system that can compress files without causing any data loss, although the compression quality isn't quite as superior as more advanced compressed file formats like FLAC or ALAC. Now, coming to the most popular audio file format out there, of course, we are talking about MP3. The cross-platform compatibility of MP3 files is the reason behind their immense popularity. Even though MP3 is a type of lossy compressed format, it doesn't cause a file to lose any crucial data. The format only removes sounds that are inaudible to human ears, which means the audio becomes more clearer and the file size is reduced as well. Today, MP3 files are supported across all digital devices, including laptops, mobile phones, PCs, etc. AAC stands for Advanced Audio Encoding. Not particularly a file format per se, AAC is an encoding technique that commonly is used as a container for other file formats, such as 3GP or M4A. AAC is the default encoding technique used across different platforms, including iTunes and iOS devices, Sony Walkmans, PlayStations, and YouTube. AGG is a bulk data file format that's primarily used in the gaming world. It's a type of compressed file format whose job is to store different assets, like audio, images, and other assets that are required to play a particular game. AGG files can be accessed across different platforms, including Windows, Mac, and even mobile devices. Now, remember Windows Media Audio that we discussed a few minutes ago? It's important to point out that WMA can act as a lossy compressed audio format as well. This version of WMA can compress audio files and drastically reduce its size by eliminating unnecessary sounds in the background. But since it's not open source, WMA didn't really gain the popularity of MP3. So that is a list of the top 10 audio and music formats commonly used in today's media world. Now, remember we asked you to hold on to the three different types of music file formats? Well, let's define them one by one and understand what they signify. Uncompressed audio formats are audio file types that, do not compress the original file whatsoever. They are ideal choices to store recordings when you don't have an issue with large files and you want to retain all the information as well. Keep in mind that uncompressed audio files are comparatively much larger and they aren't really recommended for streaming or file transfers. Lossless compressed audio formats are file types that follow different compression techniques to reduce the file size, but there is no data loss. These types of formats retain all of the original quality whilst reducing the file size through compression. Finally, lossy compressed audio file formats are an audio format where both the compression and the data loss take place simultaneously. It means the quality of the compressed file can differ from the original file, but the file sizes are much smaller. So that is everything that you need to know about the different types of audio files. Before we sign off though, I would like to share with you something else. Recently, we've received many queries from users who either have accidentally deleted audio files or are unable to play them due to malware attacks. Now, if either of these situations seem familiar, then you can use our data recovery and file repair tools to keep your audio files safe. So let's quickly take a look at how to use both of these pieces of software to both recover and repair audio files. Let's first start with data recovery. Install and launch Wondershare Recoverit on your system and then select the location where your audio files were deleted. If it's an external USB device, make sure to connect it to the computer and select the target location found under the External Devices tab. On the next screen, Recoverit will automatically start scanning that selected location. This process will only take a few minutes to complete. After the scan completes, a list of all of the deleted files will appear on your screen. At this point, all you have to do is select the audio files that you would like to restore, and then tap the Recover button in the bottom right corner to complete the process. Now, in case you're stuck with a corrupt or damaged audio file, you can use Wondershare Repairit to fix it. It has an easy-to-use interface that will allow you to repair a corrupt file in no time at all. So here is how to use Repairit on your Windows computer. Launch Repairit on your computer and then select File Repair from the left panel. Then click the Add button and select the audio files that you would like to repair. Once the files are successfully loaded on the repair timeline, tap the Repair button in the bottom right corner. Since Audio Repair only supports advanced repair, you also need to upload a sample video with the same format, which is good and can be opened. Then Repairit will automatically start repairing the selected damaged file. After the process completes, click the Preview button. If the file is playing fine, then you can click the Save All button and select the location where you would like the repaired files to be saved. So that is a wrap on today's episode about different types of audio file formats. We hope this video has cleared all your doubts about different audio formats and their real-life implementations. Still, if you do have any queries, leave them as a comment down below and we will get back to you as soon as possible. Once again, thanks for tuning in to today's episode and click the subscribe button so that you never miss out on any future updates.